Hi, I'm Agent Villegas from Best Buy. If you have a Wi-Fi dead spot in your home, I'm gonna show you how to set up a Wi-Fi extender to help get a stronger signal and remove the dead spot. First, let's talk about Wi-Fi extenders. These products are a good solution if you are trying to get additional wireless coverage in a room that seems to be a bit outside of your current wireless router's range. If you have several Wi-Fi dead spots in your home, I would suggest looking into a wireless mesh network system or a network with several wired access points. There are a few things that you are going to want to gather before setting up an extender. Your existing wireless network settings. This will include the SSID, which stands for Service Set Identifier and is otherwise called the wireless network name. You will need the current password for the wireless network, the IP address of your current router, as well as any login information to gain access to the router settings. You may also need to use a computer that has Wi-Fi capability during the setup process. One of the great things about most range extenders is that they will work with most wireless routers. You don't need to use the same brand extender as your router. I'm going to be setting up a Netgear EX7300 range extender. Your range extender may have some differences, but the setup is essentially the same. First, make sure the switch on the side is set to extender. Next, plug the range extender into an outlet that is in the same room as your wireless router. This is just for setting up the extender. You will move the extender later on in the process. The power light should turn green after a few moments. If the light doesn't turn on, press the power button. Now we are going to connect to our existing wireless network. I will go over connecting with Wi-Fi protected setup, otherwise known as WPS, as well as doing a manual connection. If your wireless router does not support WPS, skip ahead to see how to set this extender up using an alternative method. For the WPS setup, first, locate the WPS button on the extender as well as on your router. Some routers may not have a physical WPS button, but instead will have a button in the configuration page or software of the router. Check your router by accessing its configuration page. This is usually done by opening a browser on your computer, typing in the IP address of the router, and then pressing enter. Log into the router and look for a WPS setting page. There will likely be a software button there. Be prepared to use this in the next few steps. Now, press the WPS button that is on the extender. The WPS light on the extender will now start blinking. You have roughly 2 minutes now to press the physical WPS button on your router or the software button in the router configuration page. Once the router and the extender connect, the WPS light and the router link light should be lit up on the extender. If your router is dual band, meaning it is broadcasting a 2.4 gigahertz signal and a 5 gigahertz signal, you will want to repeat that process again with pressing the WPS button for both the extender and the router. This will connect your extender to both bands of your existing wireless network. Now, connect your device to the wireless network that the extender has created. It will appear in the list of wireless networks with the same name as your existing wireless network, but with an extension on the end of the name. When it asks for the Wi-Fi password, just type your existing Wi-Fi password. If your router does not support WPS, the extender can be set up manually. After plugging in the extender, connect to the extender's wireless network. Mine appears as Netgear_EXT. After it is connected, open a browser and type www.mywifiext.net and press enter. Click on the setup button. This will take you to the page to set up an account. Make sure to remember this information in the event you need to access the extender settings later on. Once done with creating an account, the range extender will start looking for available wireless networks. Find your wireless network or networks in the lists, select them, and then click on Next. Type the password for your existing wireless network. If you have 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz networks with the same password, make sure the box at the top has been selected. Once you have your password typed in, click on Next. On the next screen, type the name that you want the extended wireless network to be named. This can help to make sure you know when a device is connected to the extender or your primary wireless network from your router. If you want one wireless network name and password, click on the box next to Enable One Wi-Fi Name. After you have made your selections, click on Next. It may take a few minutes for the settings to be saved to your extender. The next screen will show your settings so you can connect any necessary devices to your extender's wireless network. After connecting devices, click the checkbox and then click on Continue. You may come to a screen that gives some direction on connecting back to your extender's configuration page. Follow the instructions for your model extender. For me, I'm going to click on the link that works for Windows. This will take me to the page showing that everything is configured. Now click on Next, and this will now show the configuration page for the extender. This page is used for any fine tweaking or advanced settings. Now that the extender has been set up, unplug it and take it to a new location in your home. A good rule of thumb is to place it about halfway between your router and the dead spot in your home. Plug the extender into an electrical outlet and wait about 1 minute for it to boot up. If the power light does not turn on, press the power button on the extender. This extender has a router link light that can tell how good of a connection the extender has back to the router. This may help with placing the extender. Green means it is the best connection. Amber means it is a good connection. Red means it is a poor connection, and off means that it is not connecting to the router. Test your devices that are connected to the extender to make sure you are able to access the internet and other network resources. I hope you thought this video was helpful in setting up an extender. Thanks for watching. Bye.